I got broads in Atlanta, just the lean in the family, credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the van, legacies, family, wait and see, they like a panda, going out like a...
Again, Dean Ambrose only has himself to blame. It was the lunatic that requested this matchup, just like Falls Count Anywhere.
It's a man that feels the need to fight for his brothers, but he's putting himself on the line.
What brothers? The Shield is no more, Renee.
It's still
is. It's a lost idea.
That doesn't just go away. His feelings.
Ambrose driving McIntyre to the barricade. A lunatic fringe, Dean Ambrose, trying to do something to somehow rally. But it has been all McIntyre here. Ambrose, though, able to thwart it. Now McIntyre bounces face first off the steel chair.
Time to switch things up.
McIntyre. Dirty deeds! McIntyre's down! The official begins the count. Ambrose looking for the last man standing victory. McIntyre stunned, trying to drag himself back to his feet. Count of seven now by the official. McIntyre back up. Ambrose, catches him with a boot. And now the relentless assault by the lunatic fringe. Maybe not driving Ambrose to the table. And now the official begins the count toward 10 again. Will Ambrose be able to make it to his feet this time? Does Dean Ambrose have anything left?
No, there's no way Ambrose has anything left.
I hate to tell you, but this man always has a little bit left. That's why this match could favor Dean Ambrose.
How in the hell are you going to favor that man right now?
But the man's still getting up. He's still moving.
Back to his feet. Claymore kick by McIntyre. A thunderous Claymore has turned the lights out. Dean Ambrose.
The fine line between blind faith and indisputable reality, Renee.
I don't disagree with you on that. I don't agree with anything he's doing right now.
Count of eight. Count of nine. Ambrose will not make the count.
Here is your winner, Drew McIntyre.